Hello and welcome to Let's Play The Getaway, part 5. We've just got out of this cell and now we are making our escape.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
I hope you know what you're doing.
Don't worry about it, Carter. He hates Jolson as much as you do.
Get this gun. I'll cover you.
Okay, I'm on it.
I need you to cover me, Hammond.
Right, I've got my guns, and I don't think that I want to work for Charlie anymore, so I'm going to go up here and shoot some of his gang. I mean, no one wants them around here. I don't, Yasmin doesn't, London doesn't, so I'm afraid they are going to have to die.
Charlie wants her dead.
Well, I want Charlie dead. So, I've run out of bullets. Nice!
You guys were always shit.
Well, I just blew them up and I've got a new machine gun. Yay! Okay, so I'm going to try and find an exit. We could go out the front door, but I know that the back door has a nice car that I want to steal. So, I'm just going to go up these stairs. Hopefully there aren't going to be any more horrible people trying to shoot me. Because I'm nearly dead. Here we go. Look at these cars. I'm going to take this one. But first, I'm going to heal up a bit because I'm not feeling too well. Oh, wait. Ha ha. Okay. Let's go into the fancy car.
Yes, just get in the car, will
ya? Just look at it. It's so pretty. I wonder how long it will stay pretty before it's a burning wreck. Okay, so far the police haven't discovered me. I'm going to be nice. I'm going to lay low and hopefully not break any laws. Besides driving incredibly fast down the middle of the road and knocking over a few keep left signs. Oh, God. Oh, damn. That didn't last long. You stupid police car. Now look what you did. My car's... not doing too... I'm gonna get a new car. That car's got a wonky wheel now. And I cannot drive with a wonky wheel. I need a new car. Something decent. So I'm going to drive this police car. Shut up, Yasmin. Get in the car. Come on, hurry up. God! That's better. Now we're going to try and get to this location as quickly as possible. I need to go and get to Charlie's house. That is where we think he is hiding Alex. So, excuse me, you are in my way. Now, get out of the way. Come on, van, get out of the way. Come on, hurry up, move. I need to get there quickly. So, wow. That's a lot of police cars. Excuse me. Oh no. My wheel is ruined. Okay, I don't want this car anymore. This car is rubbish. I need a new car. A car with good wheels. Come, Yasmin, we need to steal one of these police cars. Which one is the best one? I reckon this one. Now be careful, we don't want to drive it onto the spikes. Right, you stop shooting, I don't want to lose another wheel.
Wah, mind the spikes.
Yasmin, come on, hurry up. Hurry up, come on, get in the car.
Yasmin?
If you don't get into the car right now... okay, good. Thank you.
Drive through the cones and possibly go and get one later to wear on my head.
Yes. I'm in a hurry. I need to get there fast.
And I don't want to drive into any police cars because I want to try and keep my wheels in good condition and my indicators because I need to know where I'm going. So, oh, there's a gate. Drive around the gate and not into a car.
Take it easy. We're almost there.
Are we? I thought we were miles away. And my car is pretty much destroyed again. Let's try and get as far as we can with it before it explodes.
Get out of the way!
Okay, forget this. I'm going on the pavement. Where it's safe! And there's not so many cars. Okay, now onto the other pavement. I'm sorry, people.
But you are in the way, so,
that justifies everything. That's right. All you people run out into the road, where it's safe from my car. Because otherwise you'll get run over.
Oh, no!
Damn. Okay, well, you've parked in the right place, so I'm going to have to steal your car. Thank you very much! Oh, come on. Get into the car! Right, come on, Yasmin, get into the car, quick. Yes. We're going to get away with this one, I think. Oh. Maybe not.
Lose who?
There's no one following us. We're doing
pretty well.
But I need to find a left turn. Come on, left turn.
Come on!
Wow, no. Okay.
No, I just want to get past these police cars without having to drive through a load of spikes. Oh, come on, left turn.
I might have misjudged this. I need a left turn. Okay, here we go. But let's go on a tour.
Here we are at Nelson's Column in Trafalgar Square. In front of us, we see the National Gallery. Let us ride around the fountains because we've got police cars trying to get us. And, yeah. Okay.
Oh, no. Let us go.
Damn! How could they? Here I was trying to give a lovely tour of London, and there they are trying to arrest me.
What did I do wrong?
I think the law system is really corrupt in this place. I do not agree with it.
In fact, you might just say that all of this havoc being caused is the police officer's fault, not mine. If they let me just ride on the pavement, running people over, knocking over a few keep left signs, it'd be fine. But no, they choose to crash into my car, smash everything up. I mean, just look at this. Just let's just turn around, have a look at what the police have caused. Look. That is disgusting. It's their fault, not mine.
Come on, Yasmin, I've just stolen this car, lawfully and with goodwill. We're going to carry on.
Okay,
now I can continue on with my amazing tour. So, this is Piccadilly Circus.
It is not a circus with animals and clowns, but it is a wide open circular space, which is why it is called circus. And here is a police car, here is a black car, and here is a green car, and here is a black car, and here is a green car.
Let us carry on. We are running over a couple of people. There we are. Lovely. And, sorry.
They've gone for now.
We've lost the police.
I wonder how long that will last before they find me again and start trying to destroy everything. Oh, not very long.
Drive faster, shake them, Mark, we've got to lose them.
Now, Yasmin, if I've learnt one thing, it is not to drive as fast as you can, but to be careful, to drive sort of fast when there's a wide open space like this, but to be quite careful when there are cars everywhere.
Because this can happen, there is a car in the way, and I've got to try and
be careful, drive around it. This car.
Get out of the way!
Oh,
thanks a lot. Okay, we've got a wide open space. Let's drive fast.
Hello, police car. Has it occurred to you that you are facing the wrong way? I know you want to turn a blind eye to this, but I am causing quite a lot of trouble for the civilians of London. Hopefully, we're not going to be too far away.
I want to get there and continue on with the story.
Because I find doing commentary on these driving sections actually quite difficult. Before I started Fallout 3, I always imagined that game to be quite difficult to do commentary on, but in actuality it's quite easy. This game is actually quite tough. I mean, what are you supposed to say?
Okay, I'm driving in a straight line, I've knocked a person over, I'm driving around some sort of car here, and I'm still driving in a straight line, there's a police car in the way, I'll drive around the police car.
I said I'll drive around the police! Get out of the way! Oh, for God's sake. Now look what you've done. There's cars everywhere. It's not fair. I mean, when I've played Grand Theft Auto, I don't remember there being so many cars. These people should stop being so lazy. They should walk. What's wrong with walking? Walking is good for you. That's right. You get into the road where you belong. This car is rubbish. So I'm going to have to steal this car, because I like police cars. Unfortunately, Mark Hammond is not doing so well, so, Yasmin, get in the car.
Yasmin! What are you doing?
Come on, get in the car.
Please?
Thank you. Yeah. Mark's not doing too well, so, we better be careful from here on. Although, I think I'm pretty close to where I'm trying to get to. What way do I go? Okay, so I turn around. Oh, damn. Never mind. Yeah, Charlie's house is somewhere. Oh, I know where I am. Yes, Charlie's house is just around the corner. So we go around. Where? Knock over a bin, and around here, and there it is.
Yeah.
That was a good turn. Come, Yasmin, we must go to Charlie's house. I'm going to roll because I'm walking too slowly as a result of being shot many times.
It's good. I like having Yasmin with me.
She's not as good as dog meat. Dog meat's a much better conversationalist, but it's still quite nice. Now, you've got to be careful in this place because I remember there's quite a few nasty traps. Look at them. Look at those.
Go ahead. Careful, Mark, then.
Laser beams.
Lasers.
How do I find them?
Pressure pads on the floor, turn them on and off.
Okay, so we've got to avoid the lasers. We've got to try and get around them. And there's people in here. Right, I'm going to heal up. Whoa! Stay away from me! I don't want to be shot by you! Yeah, once you get past the lasers, then you can progress. The lasers shall turn off and Yasmin can pass. Whoa! Oh, cool, that was close. I can slightly remember where the lasers are.
Glad to see me, fellas.
But alas, my memory is not that good. So I'm going to have to try and be very careful. And Mark is nearly dead again. Come on, rest up.
What are you pissing about for? Come on, we've got to go.
Oh, no! Okay, I've
Mark,
got to try and find...
Mark, I can't get in.
The pressure. Oh.
Find it, Mark. You can't do this alone.
It's all good. Whoa. Another person. What's all this? This is a lovely room of death.
Fuck me, this is like Charlie's trophy room.
Who's trying to shoot me? Stop it. Okay, this is very tricky. We've got to try and get past all of these lasers and not touch any of them. Otherwise, you'll be gassed to death. And that's not very nice. So we roll under there. And, okay, there's a laser there, so we roll under that. Whoa! Okay. Gotta try and back ourselves against the wall. Walk past here. Okay, so far so good. Actually, I'm going to shoot his alcohol, and it serves him right. Yeah. That's 1 point towards, whatever it is I'm trying to prove by shooting alcohol bottles. Let's go up the stairs. Now those pressure pads have been pressed. The lasers have disappeared. Ah, I've got myself into a difficult situation there. Got to be careful. You don't want to stand too close to them. Okay, so we're going to try and get... all the way. There we are.
Whoa! What?
Weird. Oh, great. Now he's healing up. That is the worst thing you could possibly do when you've got lasers around. Okay, I'll let you have this one, Mark, but don't heal up around any more walls. Got to be careful. We have got to be sensible about this. It'll be alright. I'm known for my sensible methods, my careful, considerate approach to looking after my characters. I see a laser. Okay, no, come on. Mark, get your back against that wall. That's better. It's a nice house. Not as nice as the Spencer Mansion, but still pretty good.
Take the boy to Charlie.
Don't you dare shoot me. We've got to get to the top of this house and then we'll be able to find Alex. And everything shall be right with the world. But which way? There we are.
Oh.
This isn't good. There's no room to move. Nice. Sorry about the commentary, but I'm trying to concentrate as I don't want to make a single wrong move because that will result in Mark Hammond being gassed to death, and that won't be very nice. That's no good. There's no room to move. How are we going to get past here? Yes, if Mark was gassed to death, then poor Alex won't be saved. There we go. Who's shooting at me? There is blood on that wall.
Oh,
I wonder how that got there. I like this music. It's pretty good for sneaking around to. In a sort of Bugs Bunny way.
Alex!
Too late.
Ah! Fuck!
Now what?
What are we gonna do now, Mark?
I know what we're gonna do. We're gonna call the filth. Carter.
Hammond, I'm at the depot. Jake's just about to leave. He's got half the Bethnal Greenwood with him. I need some backup.
I don't give a shit. Charlie's just took off with Alex. You get the flying squad. I've got to get my boy.
I'm off the squad, Hammond. I'm suspended. My boss, the bastard you executed, he belonged to Charlie. Unless I get the Jolsons, I've got no way of clearing my name.
So what, Cobber? Don't tell me your troubles. Every cop, every villain in London wants me dead. And I've got to get my boy.
You agreed, Hammond. It's you and me now. We're going up against them.
Don't tell him anything, Mark.
Listen, Hammond. Jake must be heading for the meeting. Charlie intends to sort out all the loose ends.
Yeah? So where's he going?
There's some on cargo ship called Sol Vita at St. Saviour's Dock. He's going to take care of everyone.
Are you winding me up? What's he going there for?
What do you think? They're taking your kid there. Charlie was going to deliver you to all the other gangs. He's out to finish it. Charlie's going to blow the whole thing sky high, Hammond, so you better get there.
Shut it, copper. I'll keep my word. We're on our way, all
right? Right, go for the kid. I'll go for Jake and the detonator.
Ha! He told the copper to shut it.
A fast car would be good.
Yes, I need a car. This is a car. It'll
now,
do.
In London. It ain't what you drive, it's who's driving.
And I'm driving.
Come on, I thought you were a pro.
A pro? A pro, you say? Well, I don't know about that.
But the pedestrians of London shall be quite glad to know that after we have reached our destination, this shall be the last section of the game in which Mark Hammond drives.
Drive faster. Shake him, Mark. We've got to lose him.
Lose who? We are not being pursued. What are you talking about, Yasmin? Look, see? We just drove past a police car and it's completely ignored us. Oh, come on! Come on! Why? That's famous last words. Oh well, look at this. Excellent driving. So far, I'm doing pretty well. I haven't even smashed into anything yet. Let's see how long I can keep it up for. Normally when I say that, I get famous last words syndrome as well. Leave me alone! See? Without the police, if they weren't around, I'd be doing brilliant driving. Here I am, just taking my time, driving around the various cars, trying to get to my location quickly. Pizza Hut! Oh, no! Pizza Hut was my undoing. I was doing pretty well then, and then I got distracted by Pizza Hut, and, yeah. Oh well, never mind. Let's get to the Sol Vita. Some sort of old ship. Where are we going to find a ship? In London. Possibly in a place where there is a lot of, water. Haha, I'm a genius. Let us go there. I'm quite impressed with this car because if I was driving one of the fast, flashy cars, it would have burst into flames by now. But no, this car has lasted. Look at it! It's invincible! Those police cars stand no chance. Ow! I hear the chimes of the triads.
Oh no, triads. Can't step on it. There's no time.
No time? No time? There is plenty of time, and I am going to take it! This car is still going! That's amazing! Oh look, it's Big Bill. Oh, bum! Look, my car has been destroyed. It started, the dream dies. It was doing quite well, but now my indicator is destroyed, so I'm going to go and steal this flashy car, because it is flashy and I like flashy cars. And look, to our left we have the London Eye. It was built in 1999, and it serves as a transmitter for the nesting consciousness to awaken the Autons. Now, Yasmin, please get in the car. Please? Yasmin! I can't drive faster! You're standing there doing nothing! Now get in the car, that's better. Okay, we're driving past the red buses. The red buses. Buses that are found in London.
I've got a bad feeling about this. It's been an eventful day.
Yeah, it's been a very eventful day, but now I'm being chased by the Yardies. I don't want that. I mean, if I was shot to pieces right now and blood splattered all over the floor, who would have to tidy it up? Not me, somebody else. Also, if somebody was yawning, it would be quite unpleasant. Oh, it appears that this car is totally knackered, so I have no choice but to steal this police car because it's so shiny.
Lost them.
Well, of course we lost them. We just shot everybody. And I see you didn't bother to shut the door properly, Yasmin. Stop being so lazy. Okay, we've got to drive around these spikes. There we go. No, I will not stop now. I'm not stopping for you. I'm not stopping for anybody. Except for Pizza Hut, because I like Pizza Hut. So far, so good.
Watch it, you maniac.
Oh. Yeah. Well, I was going to change my car, but now I've seen about 3 million police cars all trying to kill me, I think I will drive on until I find a good car that doesn't have about 3 million police cars trying to kill me. Let's get out of here! It's not going too well for me right now. My car's got a wonky wheel. It's smoking, so I'm gonna get out. Come on. Oh, no. That car's smoking now. I need the car behind it. And try not to get myself run over. It is possible to get incredibly far, driving all the way, nearly there, and then suddenly getting run over by a car. Quite frustrating, but it happens. Let's move on. Oh, leave me alone! Right. Indicators tell me to go right. There we go. Oh God! I need to look after my indicators. I'm relying on them to tell me which way to go. It's not like the good old days when you had a giant arrow above your car. Need to be careful.
Take it easy, Cameron. We're almost there.
Almost there? You say that even if I have miles to drive. I don't believe you.
It's taking forever.
Yes. I still remember playing this game back in 2002, being so impressed with the massive environment. It's really good. Also, the fact that it's a recreation of a real place made it even more interesting. I'd like to see a PlayStation 3 version, just to see how far the technology's come. I mean, yeah, looking back on this, it's a little bit limiting what you can do. The buildings aren't necessarily that detailed, but it's still a good game, and I really like the storyline. However, my car is on fire! Get out! Okay, I need a new car. Don't you arrest me. Get away from me. Oh no, I'm not doing too well at all. I'm nearly dead. Come on, Yasmin, get in the car. Get in the car! Come on! Thank you! Turn that stupid siren off. Actually, I've just thought I should probably refrain from trying to drive my car into Yasmin, because if I accidentally run her over and killed her, you know, that would be quite sad. Not because she's dead, but because I'll have to start again. It'll be game over. So, that's it. I shall refrain from running Yasmin over, even if it's just for a joke. I don't want to kill her. She's helping me out. Get out the way, stupid police car. I have no patience. I'm just going to drive as carefully as I can around the police cars. Not too fast, not too slow, and not be too silly. What? It says go that way, and there is no turn that way. I'm going the wrong well. I'm gonna go back this way. See if I can find a turn. Okay, I need to go right. Clearly, I misjudged that, so, hopefully, there shall be a turn. Wow, God! No! What a horrible thing to happen! Why are all of these police officers trying to burn me? Okay, I'm going to steal your car and then run you over with it. Ha ha! Come on, Yasmin, get in the car. Oh, wait! My left indicator is destroyed. That's no good. I'm going to have to try and find a new car. Never mind. I'm sure I shall find a new car by the time I get around this corner. just get a little bit closer to my destination.
Take it easy, Hammond. We're almost there.
This time, I believe you. I don't know. I might need to turn left, but I don't know. I need a decent indicator. So, I'm going to get into this police car. I don't like getting out of the cars. I feel safe. But now, I'm nearly dead. I need to get in here. Here we go. I've got a nice set of indicators. And what do you know? I need to turn left. It is a good thing I got a new car.
Turn down there.
Oh. Well, that's it. I've left my car in perfect condition because I'm such a good driver. That is the last time I'm ever going to drive as Mark Hammond in this game. I've just rested up. Let's go. Oh, we can't walk through the rubbish. We must walk around it. Come, Yasmin. I'm quite sure that soon we shall be at the Soul Vita.
Come on, let's go.
I'm not. Here we are. The docks.
This ain't a game, Hammond. Come on, be serious.
It is a game. I'm going to be as silly as I want. Okay, got some people on the boat. That's not a good sign.
This ain't a game, Hammond. Come on, be serious.
You've said that.
This ain't a game, Hammond. Come on, be serious.
You've just said that 3 times in a row, you silly person, Yasmin.
It's all over, Mark. You've got to find the boy.
Yes. Wow. This is a bloodbath.
This ain't a game, Hammond. Be serious.
The more she repeats herself like that, the more my immersive enjoyment is destroyed. The illusion is shattered, and it seems more like a game. Okay, let's get inside this boat and see if we can find our son. These people stand no chance against me. Okay, we want a better gun. Yoink.
Great.
Let's follow Yasmin.
I'll see you on the other side of this. Good luck, Mark.
Thank you.
I'll need it. I don't know what's down here. I'll see you later.
Okay, there's going to be loads and loads of horrible people down here, all trying to kill me. So I've got to be careful. Let's heal up.
Harry, come on, we ain't got time for this.
I'm not missing this opportunity.
I'm going to be taking advantage of those explodey barrels. I'll be all right. Oh. Yeah.
How you feeling now?
Not too well. Damn. I need a new gun. There we go. I'm going to keep resting up. It's better to be safe than sorry. Who's shooting me? Stop it. That's very, very rude. Is there anyone around here? Yes.
Fucking Muppet.
Mark! The language. The language. It's not how I would have said it. I would have been more apologetic. Sorry. For shooting you in the head. Oh no, I've run out of my machine gun. This is not good. Come on, die.
Do any of you have any machine guns? I like machine guns.
I'm having to heal up every few seconds just
to be safe. Somebody's trying to drop a crate on my head!
Don't do that! I don't want to be squashed.
Who do they think I am? Crash Bandicoot! I don't stand for this nonsense. When I find whoever tried to do that, I shall shoot them. I think that it's Harry, that bloke in the green suit. Grrr.
I can hear him trying to shoot at me.
You can't shoot me, you're too far away.
But I'm going to get closer, closer, and then I'm going to kill him.
You're not playing fair. Try me.
Whoa, there's people everywhere.
Oh dear, I need to heal up.
Let's go.
Whoa.
Nice try. Trying to run me over. Who do you think you are?
Oh. Trying to drop a crate on my head.
He's up there trying to shoot at me from the balcony.
I'll get him. Come on.
Alex!
I think that's it.
Alex!
Dad, I thought you were dead!
Nice to see you too.
Oh, thank Christ you're okay.
Reunited.
Charlie's bomb. You could blow up half of London with that thing.
Ooh. If only we had some coolant.
Be careful, Dad.
Don't worry, it's not activated. But I'd love to know who's got the detonator. What took you so long, anyway?
Harry. He's making amends with his maker.
That lecherous prick eyebrows got some of the same.
You seen Charlie or Jake?
We don't have to worry about Psycho Jake anymore.
The bomb's over here. In all that carnage, they forgot to detonate it.
Well, don't think they still won't. Where's the remote? There's a detonator loose on the super junk. And where the hell's Charlie?
Who cares? You've got your kid. We're all still alive. Now let's get the hell out of here.
Well, that might be okay for you, but it's time London did without all the Jolsons.
He's right here if you want him, cos I dropped the piece. You as well, crazy man. Well, it finally looks like we've got all our problems under one roof, doesn't it?
It's the Collins gang.
Fat Man arranges a meeting. It's supposed to be a demilitarised zone. And as soon as we sit down, guns start going off all over the place. Now, we think the Fat Man might be showing a little bit of bad faith. Especially considering all the trouble we've been having with this vigilante over there. And then we find our man here trying to sneak off the boat. We come down here and find it's like a fucking slaughterhouse. Now, it's a good job I brought my boys along. Somebody better start telling me what the fuck's going on here. Otherwise, there's going to be a lot more claret spilt aboard this ship.
I can explain, Nick. I can explain everything.
Explain. Fucking explain!
Whoa. Okay.
I should hope you care for your sake, son. You've got quite a few people here would like some serious words with you.
Nick, let him speak, man. Let's find out what the hell's been going on here.
I should just kill you. God knows I want to. Of course, me. A lot of grief, Emmett.
Nick, come on, man. Let's hear him out. Let's hear what he's got to say. You're surely not going to listen to this fucking National Front lunatic.
What I tell you, I arranged this meeting to hand over the boy who's been causing you all this problem. He's caused you all an injury. He topped your people, Collins. And here he is, delivered on a silver fucking platter, just like I promised.
Shut it, fat man. You promised me the situation would be cool. No heavies. And the ship did a crawl with your boy then. You promised me the crazy man. Instead, we have to come down here and find him for himself. I think the best solution for the problem after we just do you know. Reset China, man.
Satsukon.
Mr. Bobby Lee agrees. Kill him now.
Are you all blind? Can't you see what's going on here?
Let the boy go, Nick. I'll take what's coming. It's not his fault. Let the boy and the girl go. All it's ever been about is the boy. Just hear me out.
I'm listening.
You killed Susie, Nick. Right in the street, in front of my gaff. You kidnapped Alex and blackmailed me into doing jobs all over town. The only part I couldn't figure out was why he was having me taking turns in hitting you. Then you, and then you. I did it. I admit it. And I'll take what's coming. But I was protecting my boy. And he deserves a chance, doesn't he?
Continue. This story is very interesting.
He played us all like a game of chess. Sending me against yous, and then watching you take chunks out of each other. While he sat back and smoked his fat fucking cigar.
I'll bring out the fucking violins. You're breaking my bleeding heart. You can't seriously be listening to this mad tosser. He killed his wife. I took his kid in out of my respect for his Susie. He's gone loop the fucking loop.
Why do you think he brought you all here? To give you Mark Hammond? Someone would have got to him eventually. We all know that. Either you guys or the police. Who do you think has benefited the most from all this strife? Who would like all of you lot out the way so that things were just like the good old days? And who would be mad enough to plant a bomb that would blow up half the waterfront just to make sure he had no rivals?
Oh, I saw you steer, fat man. You prefer them old days without competition. You say you want to help we with our problem. But all the while is a joke thing you have play upon we. You want to block the whole town with that?
You are a fucking dinosaur, Charlie! This is the new millennium. We make more money on porno on the internet than you ever made in the knocking shops of Soho. London is multicultural. It always was. Only people like you never realised it. I mean, you're like a bad hangover from a different era. An era that's about to end.
I'm letting you go, Mark. You earn a boy.
Really? Thank you very much.
Look, I know what you did. And I know why you did it. But it still don't make it right, does it? I lost some good lads because of you. Lads that I'm gonna miss. Now, I'm letting you go, son. But get out of London and get out tonight. Don't let me ever see your face in this town again. Do you hear me? You've spoken out of place, Mr. Collins. This man has killed many men, and he has been very bad for business.
I ask this as a favour, Mr. Lee. He'd done it for his kid, and I'd have done the same for mine.
But you're from Hammond, so. Oh, we are prepared to recognize this favor and will, at the proper time, ask a favor in return.
Now, you gonna give me a problem over this?
This boy, him killed me boy them and steal my money. So me not really too happy about him still alive. And I want the people them to think he can mess with Jamal and be taking liberties. However, for the sake of our little racial unity, I'm prepared to let him and him boy go free. Now move!
Now, you heard him, Hammond. Now get the fuck out of here and don't let me ever see your face in this town again. Do you hear? Now we can have some fun with his lordship here.
I'll miss you, big boy. But whatever you do, don't cry. I don't think you'll be getting much sympathy here.
What about the cop, Nick? He's been straight up.
Shut it, Mark. You're pushing your luck. I gave you a break because of Sue's, but I'll never go out on a limb for the filth. I can't have the filth knowing my business.
So, the boat exploded. I wonder why. We shall have to find out in the next scenario. So, that was The Getaway. This marks the halfway point of the game and the LP. I'm going to continue on with this later as DC Frank Carter. The Bargain Basement. I hope you've enjoyed the LP so far. Comment, rate, subscribe, and I shall see you next time. Thank you for watching. Bye!